So you were talking about the development of the fasting mimicking diet and how you you were looking at all these genetic pathways, and also you mentioned the ketone bodies, and what was the last thing for?
Ketone bodies and glucose.
And glucose, IGF-1,
right. IGF-1, glucose, and ketone.
And these are all things that regulate cancer growth as well.
Yes, they can regulate cancer. They do regulate many cancers. And in different ways. I mean, ketone bodies, you know, some will argue that hurt cancer cells. And but some cancers actually love to use both ketone bodies and sugar. You know?
Yeah, there was a recent publication, I think.
Yeah, so you can actually accelerate cancer growth with ketone bodies, but you can also hurt cancer cells with ketone bodies. You know, this is why ketogenic diet, you know, I wouldn't get too... you know, confident about using ketogenic diet alone against cancer cells, because of course, even fasting, a lot of cancer cells can adapt to the changed environment. So,
cancer is it's so complicated when it comes to cancer, and it seems like you really have to be careful when you're trying to treat the cancer.
And I think that there is a lot of course, interest on the ketogenic diets and cancer treatment, and it's good. I think it can do. There are situations where the ketogenic diet can hurt the cancer growth, but as for fasting, we see that you need to have, in most cases, the powerful targeted intervention with the fasting. Mm-hmm. So like fasting and chemo, mm-hmm. fasting and kinase inhibitors, fasting and immunotherapy, for example. So I will assume that the ketogenic diet alone is going to be a complementary intervention. So now, for example, we're very interested in what happens if you do fasting, ketogenic diet, and cancer treatment together, you know.
Yeah.
That I think is very promising, particularly if you do it in the sense of, and we have had, you know, patients that with very aggressive phenotypes that are doing this. So they do the periodic fasting-mimicking diet, then in between the ketogenic diet, and then they keep doing the radiotherapy, particularly like gliomas, radiotherapies and chemotherapy. And it seems to be, you know, working, are certainly very promising.
Wow. Is this an ongoing trial you're talking about, or is it just...
We haven't started, I mean, we have trials on cancer, a number of trials on cancer. We don't have one on glioma yet, but I know that some groups in Arizona, they mostly have just done it with the ketogenic diet. But because it's so aggressive, and most people, you cannot tell a glioma patient or wait until the clinical trial is ready, right? Because it's a very quick moving cancer. So in some cases we just say, look, go to your oncologist and ask them if they're okay by letting you follow a fasting plus ketogenic diet plus standard of care. So they're just adding ketogenic diet and fasting to the standard of care.
Yeah, okay. And that's for the periodic fasting, is that also including the fasting mimicking diet, which they can talk
yeah,
to?
So the fasting mimicking diet, I mean, not water only fasting, but we FMD, ketogenic diet, and standard of care. And